His previous concept in terms of name was called Boomer. Boomer because the only one able to explode a reinforced wall. He was the first one to do this. We were looking for something a bit weird. We were trying to develop personality. And instead of having a normal soldier, we decided to change some stuff. His bag in his back is red. It doesn't fit, you know, in terms of military camouflage, etc. But anyway, we were wanting to have a specific signature. And also his goggles. Welding goggles. Who will aim, you know, with a gun with such a kind of goggles? So we were trying to take a risk. We were observing, you know, the reaction of people, etc. But it works. It works really well.
This one was cool. It came from one of our designers seeing a technology that were bought by Snapchat about, you know, high definition camera, being able, you know, to track like very small details and do like some algorithm prediction. And this is how we started to work on an operator that could have this kind of super HD camera, being able, you know, to detect dust pattern on the floor and track his enemy.
We were looking for a wall, something you should never be able to pass. It took time to obtain it. And the best story doesn't come from ourselves, come from the exterior with a meta name, the Mountain Push. The Mountain Push, we never invented the Mountain Push. It's really something coming from the community. And now, as developer, when we are talking about this character, we call the strategy the Mountain Push.
Funny thing with Buck is that at the beginning we just thought about the shotgun as a secondary weapon and that's it. We never had in mind, you know, this destruction relationship and having him becoming a breacher. It's actually in season 2 that we made the change, so it will work very well with destruction and have, like, you know, opening a real vault in wall and not having like use a shotgun multiple times to have opening. He become a breacher because of the community.
The first woman when we decided to have a woman also in a game, and we started by Ash. It's an important character, a symbolic character for us as developer, and also a symbolic character for the community. We took also the liberty and the decision to make her a bit special. And you will see in the video of Heartbreak, she's more important than the others. She's a kind of link of connection between Six and all the other units.
So Blackbird, when we first started to work on him, the shield was invulnerable. And we at the time the feeling was, yeah, and it might be not enough, you know. And when we first hit live with 800 HP, it was so broken. It was the operator that we have the worst time to balance of all the history of Rainbow Six so far.
We had a concept, and this concept was called Blitz. Not the Blitz, you know. The previous Blitz, the first Blitz, one of the first operators we made. And this Blitz was an operator able to spawn during the preparation phase. And this operator has been a nightmare for players, specifically when it was played by a very good one. He was able to boom, 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 dominate an entire team during the preparation phase. And this has been such a strong trauma in intern during our tournament, etc., internal tournament, that any concept about something spawning in prep phase able to shoot was like forbidden.